أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على أشرف الأنبياء وإمام المرسلين، وعلى آله وصحابته أجمعين، والتابعين وتابع التابعين، ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. رب اشرح لي صدري، ويسر لي أمري، واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. I hope you are all well and safe and healthy. I want to talk today about the month of Sha'ban. I would like to have a closer look at the virtues of the month of Sha'ban. Sha'ban is the 8th month of the lunar calendar, of the Islamic calendar. Sha'ban, before Islam, was already an important month. Before Sha'ban, we have the month of Rajab, which is one of the sacred months, the four sacred months. We have Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hijjah, Muharram, which are together, and then comes separately Rajab. These are the four Ashhur al-Hurm, the four sacred months. So after Rajab comes Sha'ban. And then after Sha'ban comes, as we know, and it will happen in about 3 or 4 days, the month of Ramadan, the 9th month. So Sha'ban falls in between Rajab and Ramadan, two important months of the Islamic calendar. Sha'ban actually comes from the root sha'aba in Arabic, which means to scatter, to disperse. And during the pre-Islamic period, Arabs used to actually disperse and travel and scatter in the Arabian Peninsula. And these would be to search for water mainly, although there are other opinions which say that they would do that to make predatory incursions, military expeditions, because of course Rajab had just passed, and they used to respect the months of the Ashhur al-Hurm, the sacred months, among which is Rajab. So they say that after Rajab was ended, after Rajab finished, they would go out to fight, which they could not do during the sacred months. It is very important to look at the month of Sha'ban and the virtues that are contained in it, and to give it its due importance and value. And the Prophet ﷺ himself used to remind us of this fact. Of course, Ramadan comes after Sha'ban, and this will happen in about 3-4 days, inshallah. And then with Ramadan, we all know that there are many, many recommended actions, many good deeds that are we are encouraged to do during Ramadan, such as reciting Quran, praying during the nights of Ramadan, doing it in jama'ah, taraweeh, giving sadaqah during Ramadan. These things we know that are very recommended to do during the 9th month, the month of fasting. But Sha'ban is an important month also, and the Prophet ﷺ used to fast a lot himself during Sha'ban. There is a fact that the actions of every human being are presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala daily. This is based on a hadith. Weekly also, this is based on a hadith. And yearly, once a year also, this is based on a hadith. Particularly on a hadith which we will mention now, where the Prophet ﷺ was asked by Usama ibn Zayd, "Why do I see you, Ya Rasulullah, fasting during the month of Sha'ban more than in any other time?" Of course, he was referring to voluntary siyam, voluntary fasting. He ﷺ replied, "That is a month to which people do not pay much attention. It is between Rajab and Ramadan. It is the month in which the deeds are taken up to the Lord of the worlds. And I like my deeds to be taken up when I am fasting." This is in Sunan al-Nasa'i. So although he was, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, protected from any errors and faults and mistakes, and he was forgiven for anything that he had done either before or after that moment, he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, liked to fast during the month of Sha'ban, so that his actions would be presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a state when he was fasting. Then the 15th night of Sha'ban is also an important night, and it is good to remember that it falls in this month, and it is a night which has blessings, and there are ahadith also that mention this. We don't have time to mention all of these ahadith. And also it is the month that comes before Ramadan, and the shayateen are all very active, as to say, because they know that they will be chained during Ramadan. They will be chained according to the hadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, وَصُفِّدَتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. When Ramadan comes, the doors of Jannah are open, the doors of the fire are closed, and صُفِّدَتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. The shayateen are chained, they are locked down, they are tied up, so they have no more margin of action. So during these days before the coming of Ramadan, one has to be aware of this, one has to be linked to the Quran, doing dhikr, trying to have a good conduct, a good adab, and trying to do acts of ibadah, because these are dangerous days, in the sense that the shayateen are still loose. So may Allah protect us from this shayateen. May Allah give us the blessings of the month of Sha'ban, and of course the blessings of Ramadan. May Allah make us reach Ramadan with blessings, with good health, with safety, and may Allah bless us in the month of Ramadan. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.